Hello, MJ7NLK here, and welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we are looking at the brand new Radioddity CB900 Pro, which, as the name suggests, is a CB radio. It's an enhanced version of the Cobra 29 Limited, and it's a classic slide switch and dial style radio, which I'm a very big fan of. Its baby brother, the CB500, is a fabulous radio, packed with features and at a very reasonable price. I highly recommend the CB500, so it'll be interesting to see how the CB900 fares. Coming up in this video, unboxing and first look, general operation, standard power tests, modifying the radio, and expanded power tests. There is a lot to cover, so please do stick around. Thank you to Radioddity for sending me this unit for review. It will be available to purchase very soon. The product page is up on their website, and I'm told they'll be accepting orders shortly. Just to confirm, Radioddity have no input into the content of this video, and I can and will tell you exactly what I think of it, good or bad. Before we dive in, some radio news. I have just received two Retevis radios for review, the A61 and the RA89. August is going to be a busy month, as we now have in the queue for review the President Jerry, the Jimmy 3, the Washington, the Radioddity CS47, and the two Retevis units. Let me know in the comments below which radio you want to see reviewed first. I have the feeling the Washington may be the hot favourite, but the cooling fans still haven't arrived. I have some news on the Radioddity GD88 that was reviewed in my last video. I spoke with my contact at Radioddity, who has confirmed that the 300,000 digital contacts limit can be increased in a firmware update. Their technical team are working on this, and they will let me know when the update becomes available. This is great news and fantastic support from Radioddity. Keep your eyes out on the downloads page for the next firmware release and see what they've increased it to. Before we continue, here is a quick message from this video's sponsor, PCBWay. PCBWay are makers of prototype PCBs of all kinds. They also offer services like PCB assembly, CNC machining, 3D printing, sheet metal fabrication, and injection molding. Manufacturing times are exceptionally quick and delivery is super fast. I have used their services on many occasions, and PCBWay get an NLK-Media thumbs up for quality and service. Check out their website PCBWay.com for more information or follow the link in the video's description. PCBWay are also running a 10th anniversary special event, and you can claim prizes and win badges, so it's worth a look. Check out that link in the video description as well. Thank you, PCBWay, for your support to this channel, which is very much appreciated. Well, let's take a quick look at the box. Nothing to see here. So let's move on to the unboxing. So let's see what you get inside the box. We get a rather thin user manual, the radio, and an accessories pouch. Taking a quick look at the radio, certainly got a bit of weight to it, and it is a very nice classic style slide and dial radio. I do like the look of this radio. Taking a look around the sides, not much to see. On the back, we have an SO239 connector, PA and external speaker, and thank you, Radioddity, for having a removable power lead. That is great to see. Now, one thing I do notice here is there is no heatsink on the back, so this radio is not going to be outputting megawatts out of the back. So that's the quick look at the radio. Let's have a look in the accessories pouch. We have the mounting bracket, which is really nice to see that this is a painted bracket, so thank you for that. The power lead with fuse. The little accessories pack, which has all of the nuts, screws, spare fuse, and a mic clip. And we have the microphone. This is the same microphone as the CB500. Which has a nice clicky button. We have up-down buttons on the top and a button in the middle. And it is a 4-pin microphone. So that's what you get inside the box. I upgraded my camera, and I've been having awful problems with the overhead that keeps turning off. And this box, therefore, has been opened more times than my ex-wife's fridge. So let's talk about the key features of this radio. It's AM and FM, no single sideband, and it supports 26.965 to 27.405 out of the box. So there is no support here for FM UK frequencies, which are 27.60125 to 27.99125. We have independent TX and RX noise reduction, 12 and 24 volt compatible. It has noise blanker and ANL filter. Every radio needs an anal filter. Vox and PA mode. Supports weather alerts, although this is bugger all use to anybody in the UK and the EU, but it's a great feature to have in the radio for our North American brothers and sisters. SWR alert, talkback, automatic squelch control, and yes, it does have a Roger beep. Mic gain and RF gain, and the audio output on the speaker is 2 watts at 8 ohms, so quite a lot of stuff inside. So let's validate the weight of the unit. Let's pop it on the scales. And it is a chonkus 1 kilogram, 999.25 grams, so quite heavy. So let's have a look at the radio. General usage. Let's turn it on. Lovely little LCD display there. That's really nice to see your channel and your rotary dial. So quickly across the top for the slide switches, we have noise blanker and ANL. You have your noise reduction system, which is off, on, or set to change the RX and TX settings for that. Same for Vox. You have CBPA and weather alert switch, your AM and FM selector. And it's an awful shame that there isn't a three-way option here with FM UK on it. You've got channel 9, emergency channel, quick switch, or in normal mode. The dials along the front, you have your volume on the outside and your squelch, automatic squelch control, or your squelch settings here. You have mic gain, RF gain, and talk back. Very nice. The microphone has your up-down buttons and a center button. The center button is used for switching the display between SWR and RF mode. Nice. Then you can push and hold the rotary dial to get into your menu system. And here we have key beep, Roger beep, dimmer, display type, display mode, mic type, scan type, echo, echo volume, echo delay, weather alerts, timeout timer, SWR warning, you have your PA, automatic squelch control, weather alert squelch, and reset. So if we want to turn the key beep on, we simply push the rotary dial again, use the up on the microphone to select it, and then just push the rotary dial again. So it's really, really nice, simple, and easy to use. So let's undertake a standard power test. We're in FM, channel 20 midband. And let's see what we're outputting. That's about 3.6 watts on FM. Let's have a look at AM for a carrier test. It's about the same, 3.6 watts, and then we'll do a tone test. It's about 13 watts, 12 and a half, 13 watts. So, yeah, really good on AM. That's really quite impressive. So that's the standard power test. Obviously, I can't do FM UK. Let's open this thing up and see what options there are inside. While I'm opening the radio up, I thought I'd show you this, which is a very nice little electric screwdriver that I got from PCBWay. It's extremely powerful and it's quite clever. You simply push this button and then twist it in the direction that you want it to go. So pushing the button and twisting to the right will do it up. Pushing the button and twisting backwards will undo. And it's extremely powerful. So let's just get one of these. And we'll have this one out. So a really nice little addition. So thank you, PCBWay. That's very nice. Let's get the disclaimer out of the way. Modifying a radio is at your own risk. You will have legal obligations in your region with regards to radio transmissions, licensing and power outputs. You should always ensure that you are not causing a nuisance and, more importantly, not causing any radio interference or distress to others. Please do not break the law in your region. The information provided in this section of the video is intended for countries that have a higher than 4 watt power limit. Laws do change, so ensure you have researched the current laws in your region. So opening the radio up, you can see that it's emptier than a Unix underpants, but, well, it's not that bad, really. I mean, half of the case is just empty void. They could have made this considerably smaller, but I guess they want to conform to a standard radio size. The official documentation for expansion is a closely guarded secret and is only available to approved technical personnel. However, it might look something similar to this. But then again, it might not. Good to see that there are 45 channels, so it looks like alphas are supported. And I notice here, this is the jumper that is referred to in the diagram that you haven't seen. And it really is as simple as moving the jumper from position 1-2 to position 2-3. Now, on a lot of other radios, you'd have a wire, and there is a set of wires here with a line between them. And I suspect what would happen is if you had a wire fitted in there, you would have to cut the wire in order to enable the expanded power mode. So that's my assumption. But according to the documentation, you don't need to do anything else apart from move the jumper to enable the high power mode. And potentially you can get up to 8 watts out of the radio in that expanded mode. So let's put it back together and see what that's done. So let's have a quick look at the changes to the menu system. You can see that there is now a D displayed here. That is the band. In order to adjust the band, you have to double short press the rotary dial, and then you can select whichever band you particularly want, and then you long press to acknowledge the band selection. So that's nice and simple. So we'll do a FM test, but before we do that, you need to go into the menu. So long press the rotary, and in the menu, you'll see two new options. You've got RF power, which has a low and a high mode, and you have the FM deviation setting, which is set to 2 kilohertz. So really nice. Thank you, Radioddity, for putting a FM deviation setting into the system. So we're on high power. We are going to test for FM. Let's see what we get. So we're getting about 7.3 watts on FM. Let's have a look at AM for a carrier test. About 7.4 watts. Let's do a tone test. Okay, we're getting about 16.5 watts on the AM tone test. So the expansion's pretty good on this radio. One other thing to note is that we do get alphas, which are denoted by a full stop between the two numbers. So 1.9 is the alpha for 19, then we have channel 19. So that's really good to see. Okay, with regards to the UK FM 40, in band block E, the channel is 27605 and we want 60125. But we do have an additional option in the menu, which is the 5 kilohertz decrement menu, T0 and T5, that you would normally have on a president radio. If we go into the menu system, then you'll have this option, minus 5 kilohertz. So if we turn that on, then effectively we can get to 27.600. And I can confirm that on a president radio, we're on the UK FM 40 channel 1, which is 27.60125. Test radio test. It is receiving, but this only displays to 3 decimal places, 27.600. So anyway, it would be nice if they had a band here for UK FM and had the UK FM 40 already preloaded. Now, with regards to the send and receive quality, the TX and RX quality on the radio, limited testing that I've done, it sounds excellent. I've been very pleased with the quality that I'm hearing from the radio. I need a bit more time in the field with it to, like I did with the CB500, to be able to sort of report back definitively on that. But so far, from what I'm hearing, very, very good. One quick thing to note is that band block D on this radio is the equivalent of band block A on a President radio. So I don't know why the band blocks in the ABCs, etc., between these radios are different, but that shouldn't make any difference. You just need to learn your band blocks. Thank you to Radioddity for sending me this unit for review. It's a lovely looking radio and the front layout is great, making it super simple to use. The little LCD screen is a nice addition which allows for a proper menu system which has been very well implemented. Expansion is super simple. The power increase is modest but good enough for most people. And the three additional menu options in expansion mode are well received. Everything is here with the exception of supporting the UK FM 40. It would have been nice to have had a three mode selector with a FM UK option, or at the minimum a band block dedicated to these frequencies. However, the LCD display would also need to have been updated to move it from 3 to 4 decimal places. The what's in the box listing on the website states that it has a 2 amp spare fuse, but the manual and the current drain state 3 amp. A very minor item, but this radio is so new that there are bound to be a few little bits like this. So to sum it up, another great addition to the Radioddity CB radio lineup, and priced at around £100, it's great value for money, just like the CB500 is. Would I choose it over the Richard or the Walker 2? No, they are superior radios, but they cost twice the money. I think Radioddity will sell a lot of these radios, as the price and feature set are hard to beat. I hope you found the information in this video helpful. If you did, then please help the channel out by giving it a thumbs up and subscribing. This really does help to ensure that I can continue to provide content. Please feel free to buy me a coffee. Details are in the description below. And if you have any questions or comments, then you know what to do. All I ask is that you keep it respectful. Trolls and nasty know-it-alls need not apply. Well, until next time, stay safe, stay happy, and catch you in the next one.